Shabbat shalom, Rabotai. Shabbat shalom, Zadlabat Hashem, Bishrut Rabbi Chaim Pinto, Bishrut my grandfather, Rabbi Moshe Aharon Pinto, and Bishrut Chag Chanukah, may HaKadosh Baruch Hu bless everyone with all the berachot.
Amen.
Kibisiyata Teshmaya Gdola.
Amen. May
HaKadosh Baruch Hu open all the gates of Panasa, and Yeshua, and Shefa, and Refua, and Panasa, and all the berachot. Amen. Kinyat
Amen.
In Rabotai, today and tomorrow, we're mamash coming to a big opportunity that is not something that comes once a year, something that comes every few years. As we know, Rabotai, Be'ezrat Hashem, tonight, we're going to have three separate holy occasions that all fall on the same day. On one side, we have Shabbat, Ki Mikora Be'echa, all the bracha of the week comes from Shabbat. We have Rosh Chodesh Tov, and we have Chanukah, which actually, tomorrow, what are we going to be taking out? We're going to be taking out three books. One book for Rosh Chodesh, one book for Shabbat, the reading of Shabbat, and one book of Chanukah, which is something that is amazing. You know, about time my grandfather, every few years when this occasion would fall, where he would take out three sefarim, three sefer Torahs, he would say something amazing. He would get up, and before they take out the sefer Torahs, he would give a dvar Torah. And he would say, you know, on Rosh Hashana, the Zohar Kadosh says that HaKadosh Baruch Hu takes out three books, and those three books are three books of judgment, where he leads the world, he judges the world with the attribute of judgment, with three books of judgment. As we know about it with the Zohar Kadosh said, and we mentioned this in the past, that Chanukah is actually the point of time in the year where what was judged on Rosh Hashanah gets put into act. What does that mean? It means, yes, we are judged from Rosh Hashanah to Rosh Hashanah, but the judgment that we are judged only starts when? Chanukah. So it starts from Chanukah to Chanukah. So the full year of action actually goes from Chanukah to Chanukah. If a person, Chas v'Shalom, something happens to him right after Rosh Hashanah, it's not what was judged a few days earlier. It's what was judged the previous year. Because the new judgment only gets put into play when? Chanukah. So we see, Rabotai, the resemblance of Chanukah and Rosh Hashanah. So Rabbi Moshe, my grandfather, what do we say? On Rosh Hashanah, HaKadosh Baruch Hu took out three books and led the world and judged the world with judgment. Today, we have the opportunity where we take out three books of what? Of kindness, of chesed. And HaKadosh Baruch Hu leads the world and judges the world with what? With complete chesed, with complete kindness. Well, Rabotai, we have the opportunity to really bring upon ourselves a miracle, to bring upon ourselves a new judgment, to bring upon ourselves a new fate of the year to come. As we know, Rabotai, Chanukah is not finished. We're still, what, in the fifth, sixth night. As we know, Rabotai, we have until the eighth night to really pray, to really change something. We say, Bayamim Ahem, Bazman Azeh. The miracle happened in those days, but it's still active. We can still draw that merit and that light from that miracle, Layamim Ahem, Bazman Azeh, in today's generation. Abote, take the opportunity. We are like, Be'ezrat Hashem, this Shabbat, like a small Rosh Hashanah. It is like Mamash, a small Rosh Hashanah, but the difference is, Rosh Hashanah before was judged in the attribute of judgment, of Gvura. And today we're going to be judged an attribute of what? Of chesed, of kindness. Rabotai, it's an opportunity to do as much as limud as possible, as much as study as possible, to do as much as mitzvot as possible, to bring as much as simcha as possible, to strengthen the family, to maybe take upon ourselves a new mitzvah. Rabotai, it's mamash an opportunity, Rabotai, that we can change all aspects in our life. In this week's parasha, Rabotai, what do we read? Ve'im miketz shenatayim. Some of the mefarshim explain, what is ve'im miketz shenatayim? Miketz, what does the ketz mean? End. End of what? End of suffering. We see Yosef HaTzadik until this point was in the jail, he was a slave, he was sold from the house of Potiphar to here, to there. And in this parasha, Yosef HaTzadik goes from being a slave to be what? A king. Abotai, it's the time where we can truly give an end to all our suffering, to end all our hardships, to end all the things that we don't like in our lives. Bring down a miracle, bring down bracha, and bring down light. And Rabotai, it's all possible, Be'ezrat Hashem, with the day that we're all approaching, Chanukah, Shabbat, Rosh Chodesh, something that is unbelievable. You have the light of Shabbat, which we say, Ki Mekora Be'echa, the source of all bracha for the entire week. You have Chanukah, which represents miracles. And you have Rosh Chodesh, which represents the renewing of the Shekhinah. Rabotai, it's something that, it's a compilation of so many things that we can speak hours. The Zohar Kadosh can speak hours just about Rosh Hashanah, and if Rosh Hashanah falls on Shabbat, what extra light it is. Rabotai, we have Chanukah put on top of that. Rabotai, use the opportunity. Get up, do a mitzvah, keep simcha, make the Shabbat count. Make the Shabbat, Rabotai, a Shabbat of light, a Shabbat of Kedusha, and a Shabbat of simcha. And may that merit, may HaKadosh Baruch Hu bless us with all the berachot, spell us shifat bididai, and may all our prayers be heard, and may all our wishes be fulfilled. Amen. Amen.